Hey guys, this is our second recording of this part because Camtasia decided my voice wasn't important. So I'm joined with
Soviet Steve
and Wheatley.
And incidentally, the Soviet guy is the villain. Who would have guessed?
He's so good at it.
Me, I would have guessed.
No, you're British. Shush.
Go ahead and say your line.
I've never seen magic activate without an incantation before. High-level demons such as myself draw the circles and chant the lines in our minds instead. Did you really think you would be safe if you never gave me the chance to speak? How foolish.
No incantations?
How dare you!
Oh, we get to watch this part again. With the demon lords back to him, Lizette grabbed his chance and rushed forward. But inches before the tip of his blade brushed against Gardas, the demon lord evaded and countered with a heavy blow.
Ah, you monster!
If by monster you mean a hideous, pitiful creature, then surely you're referring to yourself.
Princess, run away. Leave him to me. You can avenge my death when you get stronger.
He cried out as he parried Gardas' sword. His back to me. Don't be ridiculous. There's no way I can leave you, my knight. My best friend. And just run away. Friend zoned.
So hard.
He
left cracks in the floor when he hit.
Lizette paused. I couldn't see his expression, but Gardas could, and the unpleasant smirk floated on the demon's lips.
So, it's unrequited.
Shut up!
Yeah.
Unnerved, Lizette's skills rapidly deteriorated. Words. Gardas' words had shaken him, and his rage rendered his own attacks chaotic. I tried to call out to him, but it was too late. Gardas quickly slipped beside him and smashed the hilt of his sword onto Lizette's handguard. I'd like to repeat, we don't get to see any of this shit.
Nope.
You can use the power of imagination.
You know, it's like in Dragon Ball Z thing where they're moving too fast to see.
There wasn't any blood, but his bones were undoubtedly bruised, because that can happen. Unable to withstand the pain, Lizette let his sword fall to the floor with a clatter.
Oh wow, if this is Dragon Ball Z, Lizette is so Yamcha.
Gardas didn't miss his chance and punched Lizette in the stomach. At least it's better than being punched in other places.
Except he probably had a chest plate.
His cape covered back bent horribly. Not supposed to bend that way.
His spine is made of pipe cleaner, so it's fine.
He looks mildly discomforted.
He's like, oh, I've been slightly inconvenienced by this.
Also, he's not wearing armor. Brilliant. Did you really think you could defeat me like that? You underestimated me.
Yeah, for a moment there, yeah, I kinda did.
That quote. Ignoring his agony, Lizette struggled to his feet and tried to straighten his posture, even though he's standing completely straight.
Not a care in the world.
Gardas, however, had other ideas and grabbed the knight by the throat, lifting him onto his tippy toes. It was nothing short of a nightmare.
Yeah, just look at that arm holding him.
with just one hand, Gardas had lifted up a fully grown man with the utmost ease. His smile felt ruthless and cruel, yet captivating and beautiful. Stop writing fanfics in the corner! He could have snapped Lizette's neck in two that instant, but instead he chose to squeeze, taking sadistic pleasure in the knight's agonized expression.
Again, just kiss him, you fool!
And then they Frenched.
Oh god, that video. As he squeezed harder and harder, his sharp claws caught on Lizette's fragile skin and sent a rich crimson drop trickling down his neck.
We want Lizette! Fanfiction.
Say, if I offer to save your life in exchange for hers, do you think the princess would agree to it?
Just kill me! I'd rather die than be a burden on her.
What the hell is happening to my face?
I think you're trying to laugh, but you just fell asleep.
Looks like he's having a really uncomfortable time on the toilet. Anyway.
Can you imagine going to sleep while holding someone up in the air by their throat?
Nap time. Anyway. How noble. A knight who would sacrifice himself for his princess, eh? This is really getting interesting. How much will you get in return, I wonder? I'm dying to know.
Third base.
You scum. I have no idea which one of us said that.
What a gratifying thing to say. You've certainly lived up to my expectations, both of you. You've entertained me plenty. So, I think I'll reward you.
What are you doing? Wait, what are you?
A miserable pile of... No, that's not different. Why don't we make a contract, O brave knight of the princess?
I'll
take that as a yes.
No! Stop! The bees! The bees!
They're in my eyes. They're on my neck.
Ooh, flashy.
That bling is gonna go great with my swagger. This is...
One moment.
It's a magical device. If either you or the princess dare to leave my kingdom, then you, her beloved knight, will disappear. Now just say that out loud.
Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark.
Disappear?
Why are you?
I changed my mind. It might be fun keeping a champion's knight as a pet.
Stop joking around. Remove it right now. Gardas gave a satisfied smile, amused by my fury.
Great troll. Yes, Your Highness, right this instant. Idiot, as if I'd do that. However, because I'm a nice person, I'll let you stay in my castle in the meantime. As long as you don't try to escape, of course.
What?
While you're here, feel free to try and assassinate me as many times as you want. I'll never get bored. It's like killing two birds with one stone, right? A wonderful idea.
Idiot, don't underestimate me. Sparing me now means I'll get to kill you later.
Okay, I'll just snap both your necks now.
Oh crap.
Damn it, Chris.
Not to mention, if I just abandon my knight and escape, I could leak everything I know about your kingdom. I am a smart one.
Well, yeah, oh crap, you're right. Better kill both of you right away. My, aren't you a kind little Miss Champion for going out of your way to warn me? Oh well. You can run away if you want, but the moment you leave, your dear friend will go poof.
That doesn't sound so bad.
Fuck him.
He'll get very hairy.
I mean, can't you just use the word, like, disintegrate or something?
Poof. Yeah, just go poof. That doesn't sound badass. Anyway. You put on a splendid show tonight. Keep up the good work.
Wait! Are you trying to run away? I am the smart one. I am the smart one.
I've had my share of children's games. If you want to play in my bed too, you'll need to grow up a bit.
PJ Monopoly Slumber Party!
Yay!
Yay!
What? I forgot to bring Risk with me.
Oh, damn.
Well, call the whole evening off.
Leaving that utterly shameless line, Gratis strolled out of the room and disappeared into the corridor. We were finally alone, and neither I nor Lizette could move a muscle. I was dumbfounded by the fact that Gardas completely outstripped me in the terms of combat, and regret swirled in my heart over what happened to Lizette, dumb fuck. I clenched my fist and punched the floor, crack shooting across the dry surface, and then I realized I'd never be able to use that hand again.
My deepest apologies, Your Highness. I am your knight, yet I've become nothing but a burden.
Yes, you have.
Yes, you got me battle royaled.
I was stuck by the change in his voice. For him, the shame was worse than death. We can change that.
Yeah. It's like he's Japanese or something. It's weird.
Seeing him blame himself like that made my chest ache. That's right. As his princess, I need to pull myself together.
Princess, please allow me to redeem myself through that. Seppuku!
Have you guys seen the newest episode of American Dad, where the dodo bird keeps trying to constantly kill himself?
No.
Never. I don't see that series. I don't watch TV, sadly. Watching Breaking Bad a bunch.
I need to stream that tonight, just so you guys can see that, because now all I can picture is him doing what the dodo bird did and keep constantly trying to kill himself and fail. Don't be an idiot. Why would I want you to do that?
But...
it's not your fault. Not only did I, as a champion, fail to defeat the Demon Lord, I couldn't even protect my subordinate. I'm the one you should blame.
No, you're wrong. It's my... what? Oh.
I stopped Lizette, agitated reply, by raising my hand and pulling myself up against the wall. The crescent moon smirked at us from the window, reminding me of that man's hard smile that I just wrote fan fictions about. Staring at the moon, I rubbed the blood off my lips and said, "We haven't finished yet, Lizette. Do you still remember our promise?"
Eh?
You forgot the promise that we made in the barrel when I was grabbing something?
You were grabbing something. My priorities were elsewhere.
I vowed not to let you die, remember? No matter what happens, I'm going to save you. Because obviously you can't do shit yourself.
Princess. I imagine, like, tears rolling down his face in a very manly way, you know?
He underestimated us. He'll let his guard down eventually, and we'll use that chance to get him. We'll defeat that man and go home again together.
I heard that, Chris.
I smiled at him, showing my resolution. It was hard to keep myself standing, my legs wobbly and my arms shaking. And with that, guys, we will see you next time.